Hey, here's a map for you. Take a good look at it. Does it make you uncomfortable? Chances are it does. Let's play a quick game. What's this blob? Spain, of course. What's this? Nothing other than South America. How about that? That's still Colorado or Wyoming. Were these maps made incorrectly? Well, yes, but so are the traditional flat maps you see in classrooms and on the internet. Ignoring the distortion made by projecting a sphere onto a flat surface due to the curvature of the Earth, there is nothing wrong with this map. On a cosmic scale, there is nothing right or wrong about north, south, or whatever direction being up. In outer space, up and down are completely arbitrary to your position, and only really dictated by gravity, like here on Earth. If maps that featured south as up were objectively incorrect, and north truly is synonymous for up, then weird and ridiculous arguments such as "it doesn't rain in Australia because it's at the bottom of the world" start to sound just a little bit more valid. But which bigwig or bigwigs decided that north, and not any other direction, would be at the top? Well, a lot of them. But before them, maps were aligned so east was facing up, to match the rising of the sun. To orient or orientate something means to align it properly, and the Latin word orientum, the root word of said words, means east in English, which is why Eastern Asia is commonly referred to as the Orient. However, maps of ancient Egypt used a south-up format, with the mouth of the Nile at the bottom, because water tends to flow downwards, because, you know, gravity and pressure and stuff like that. This is interesting because the Nile flows north, which is the opposite direction of most rivers. The Nile was so important that there wasn't really a competition to see what feature maps would be based on. So important that it beat out the sun deity Re, a very important god to ancient Egypt. Now, take a leap forward in time to pre-Enlightenment Europe, when exploring beyond Europe was a novelty. When exploring other places around the world, the Europeans thought themselves to be superior to the natives of whatever soil they set foot on. Not necessarily because they had different color skin, but because they didn't practice Christianity. To many, devotion to God was an act of a civilized society. Take the Spanish, for example. When Columbus made his infamous journey across the Atlantic in the Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria, Spain was Christian. Only Christian. The Spanish Inquisition expelled the Jews, converted the Muslims, and hunted down any supposed heretic. Later on, during and after the Protestant Reformation, Spain, and other countries, felt an obligation to reclaim the souls lost to Protestantism by converting new ones in the New World. To them, saving people from supposed damnation, even if they were few in numbers, was worth the death of numerous non-believers. To many conquistadors, spreading the word of Catholicism was as important as turning a prophet. Back to the main point, Spain and all of Europe tended to believe themselves to be culturally and religiously superior to the rest of the world, and it was their duty to spread the word of Christianity. Since all of the colonizing was done by Europe, and colonization requires maps, unsurprisingly, the Europeans made the maps. Even in our society today, up is considered to be better than down. In 2017, Microsoft made almost $90 billion in revenue, but that's just not good enough. Look up. In the same category, Google made almost $110 billion. Are you a powerful and successful politician? Look up. There's almost always someone more powerful. Why would you want to convey your message to the people from a soapbox when you can deliver it from a grand balcony? Even in religious context, up is often better. Why would you want to be on Earth when you can be in the heavens? This is not unique to the major religions of today. Various folk religions across the globe had spiritual beliefs that the most divine of deities were the stars, planets, and constellations. The point is, throughout human history, up has been considered better than down. Naturally, European mapmakers chose themselves to be on top of the map. That provides a good rationale for putting north at the top, but it's not the whole story. After the fall of the Roman Empire, most of the art, science, philosophy, and other subjects of interest were lost for centuries. One of those works was a map made by Ptolemy, a Greco-Roman academic from Alexandria, Egypt. He made maps of the world, albeit the old world, which were quite accurate for the time. The element of interest is that he put north at the top. To this day, nobody knows why exactly he did this. Many European mapmakers, which we talked about before, admired his work when it resurfaced at the end of the Middle Ages. If you're wondering why east, west, north-northwest, or some totally arbitrary direction is not at the top, it's because of compasses. The Earth has a magnetic north and south, as well as a north star to guide those northern explorers, which made navigation based on one of those two directions. Most civilizations use north, while some, like the Chinese at one point, used south. But why does it matter which direction is at the top? With north being up, people who look at maps tend to exhibit a cultural bias, especially if they are from Europe or North America. They exhibit a belief, which may be conscious or subconscious, that their country and its allies are better than others. Is this racist or discriminatory? No. In most categories, the North is better, with safer communities, better education, and higher incomes and luxuries. It's totally natural to want your country to do better and be the best. Not everybody can be a world power. Take the FIFA World Cup, for example. If the team you support is playing against Turkey, it's not racist or anything wrong to want Turkey to lose. It's simply human nature and totally normal. It's a skill we humans have used for thousands of years in order to survive in both small groups and large nations. Although it has caused numerous conflicts, we would not be here without it. However, that certainly does not mean we shouldn't try and take something into consideration from a different point of view. When people view South Up maps, people tend to get confused. However, it is in this confusion that the North-South bias disappears. Instead of thinking about politics, poverty, GDP, GPA, oppression, opportunity, and all sorts of socioeconomic stuff, people tend to see the geography for what it really is. What about Australia, the land down under? Under what? Uluru, also known as Ayers Rock? Maybe. But the title makes little sense. There have been people in South America and Australia who have made South Up maps as political statements, promoting the importance of the Southern Hemisphere. Should North continue to be up? Of course. There's no need to change the status quo and cause confusion for no reason. North Up maps are a staple of our collective culture and provide simple means for navigation, even among the general population, which is why the infamous blue marble was reversed to be recognizable. However, it would be useful to view the world from a different perspective once in a while. That sense of understanding different worldviews and perspectives could inspire cooperation that would cause our species to do extraordinary things, like go beyond Earth, cure diseases, and so much more. And until next time, thanks for watching.